Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone, this is Ashima, and in this video we'll be talking about daily news events or daily current affairs. And we'll be talking about those news events in a bit of detail so that it is helpful for all the examination aspirants. So whether you're preparing for a banking examination or SSCA related examination, that is CGL, CHSL, CPO, or any other examination for that purpose, it is going to be helpful. In fact, it is going to be helpful for your interviews and descriptive examinations as well, because the medium or the idea of the video is to give more information in less time with more detail as much as possible from examination prospect. So going to be helpful. You can easily share this video. Also, do like the video and share the video if you find this helpful. And for those who want to practice questions, for all of your practice, we have everyday live free quiz that happens. And this quiz happens on Entry app. So you can download the app from Google Play Store. And after that, you can opt for the language you want. Because there are various languages you can pick the app in as well as the quiz in. And furthermore, once you do that, you can also avail various free videos that are available, various courses that are available for purchase. So do download the app and check that out. Now we'll be beginning with our discussion. The first news event we are going to talk about is standard personal accident cover. Now this standard personal accident cover has been launched by IRDAI. Now IRDAI in January had announced its intentions of launching such insurance products which are applicable for all the platforms, all the general insurance companies. That is, all the insurance companies will be implementing the same standards. So for that part, the first in its range has come, and that is the standard insurance personal accident cover. So first of all, this has been launched by IRDAI. Second of all, there is a time limit for all the companies to implement it also. So the last date is 1 April 2021. So by 1st of April 2021, all insurance companies and health insurers, general insurers, all of them mandatorily have to offer it. Like, it is not an option, it is a compulsion that is there. Second of all, there's a limit on maximum assured limit and minimum insured limit. So minimum assured limit is going to be 2.5 lakh, whereas the maximum amount that can be insured under this scheme is 1 crore. Right now, what is the universal regulation? First of all, is the minimum and maximum, but apart from that, what are the universal regulations that are there? Now, first of all, if any person dies within 12 months from the date of accident, in that case, entire sum that is assured will be paid by the insurance company to the person. Second of all, if someone faces a permanent or total disablement, permanent total disability is there because of the accident, in that case also 100% of the assured amount is going to be paid by the insurance company to the insurer. Third thing, if it is a partial disability, in that case partial amount is going to be given, that is up to 50%. Now this is up to, not exactly 50%, but up to 50% is going to be given. Fourth of all, there's an optional cover in certain cases also. What is this optional cover that is given? That is, if any person sustains the injury of the accident but is incapable of joining the work they are doing, so they are not able to continue their employment for the certain period of time, even though they have sustained the injury, in that case, compensation of 0.2% of the base sum in a week will be given to the insuree till they get back to work, right? So even if you're sitting at home, you have done this insurance, even if you're sitting at home because of the accident, you can still gain certain amount out of it, right? Now, policyholder will get the benefit under the base cover even after the policy period has ended. But the benefits will be availed within 12 months from the date of the accident only, right? Now, under the policy, even hospitalization expenses will be compensated. Now, how much hospitalization limit is going to be compensated? So, 10% of the hospitalization charges are going to be compensated under this insurance policy. And one-time educational grant is also going to be there. So, one-time educational grant is of again 10% of the base amount. So 10% of base amount of the insured person is going to be given as one-time educational grant. But for this, the children should be pursuing educational course, first of all. Second of all, should not be over the age of 25. So the child should not be above the age of 25 and should be pursuing an educational course for the matter. Right, and this is going to be given or payable to the dependent of the accident or of the insured. Next, 5%. So the sum insured will be increased by 5% every year for each claim-free policy. So policy is required to be renewed without a break, and 5% increment is going to be seen over. These are a few regulations, and these regulations are going to be applicable for all the insurance companies, and it is compulsory for all insurance companies to bring this insurance into force. Right? Next, Saras Ajivika Mela 2021, which was held in Noida Heart recently. Noida Heart is the place where it is being organized. So, what is the purpose? First of all, who inaugurated it? Inaugurated by Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Minister. And who is that? Narendra Singh Tomar. Second of all, when was it started? On 26th of February it was started, 14th of March it is going to end. Third of all, what is who is organizing it? Ministry of Rural Development is organizing it. Fourth of all, who is the beneficiary of this, or what is the purpose of this Mela that is held? So for that part, it is targeting at women self-help groups, that is increment of women entrepreneurship, right? So increment of women entrepreneurship, promotion of women entrepreneurship is the purpose of it, and for that same purpose this has been brought into picture. So in this platform, what is given to women for this for self-help groups of women is to showcase their skills, to sell their products and build links with bulk buyers under this platform. So it basically provides a platform. Now they have to utilize their skills and showcase the skills to sell the products using this platform. Right? Then events are conducted for rural self-help group women, most of it, or priority is for rural self-help groups, and it is being conducted under the mission for Grameen sector only, right? So Ministry of Rural Development is involved because rural self-help groups are the ones which are promoted over here on a larger scale, right? Then next is FATF. Now Financial Action Task Force, or FATF, has also come to news recently because of certain countries that have been added to the list, certain countries that have been removed from the list. So first of all, we'll talk about FATF right over here, so that when we move ahead, we go with the countries itself. So first of all, what is FATF full form? FATF stands for Financial Action Task Force. Now, what is the purpose of this? It is basically to stop money laundering, or to keep a tab on money laundering, as well as to keep a tab on all the funding that is given to terrorism organization or terrorist organization. So stop terrorism funding or financing, and to stop money laundering is the purpose of FATF, right? Now it was initially the initiative of G7 countries. So here you need to remember who had helped in establishment of FATF, that is G7 countries in 1989, right? Then the third thing that is there is the president, and the fourth is the headquarters. So headquarters are in Paris in France, and the president of FATF currently is Marcus Plier is the current president of FATF. Right, now moving ahead to what has been kept and what has been removed. So in that part, North Korea and Iran are the only two countries which are in the blacklist of FATF. Rest all countries are in grey list or removed from the list. Pakistan has been retained in the grey list because its steps to combat terrorism have not yet been proven as helpful ones, or they do not seem as strong steps. Then Morocco, Burkina Faso, Senegal and Cayman Islands. These are the four countries that have been added to the grey list now. So Four new countries have been added, making a total of around 20 countries which are under the grey list of FAQ. Right? Then going ahead, such iconic places, for that 12 sites have been identified which are going to be transformed into Swachh tourist destinations now. So it is under Swachh Iconic Places Initiative, which was launched. This is the fourth edition of phase 4 that has been announced, in which 12 sites have been identified. Before this also, there have been three other phases in which further more sites were added. Now, what are the 12 places? Ajanta Caves of Maharashtra, Sanchi Stupa of Madhya Pradesh, Kumbhalgarh Fort of Rajasthan, Jaisalmer Fort of Rajasthan, Ramdevada of Rajasthan, Golconda Fort, Telangana, Sun Temple, Odisha, Rock Garden, Chandigarh, Dal Lake, Jammu and Kashmir, Banke Bihari Temple, UP, Agra Fort, UP, and Kalighat Temple, West Bengal. Now, over here, you need to remember the name of the place and the state, because the question can be asked both ways. Example, they can ask you, where is Ramdevada? That you have to answer in Jaisalmer, Rajasthan. Or they can ask you that which place of Chandigarh has been added to the 12 iconic sites in the phase 4 list released recently. So that is going to be Rock Garden. So you need to remember the state, city if possible, city also if possible, and where is it and what is the name of the place that has been added to the 12 sites of SIP. Next. President Xi Jinping has declared a complete victory in eradication of poverty in China. Now, eradication of poverty is under the Sustainable Development Goals of United Nations, and these goals need to be completed by 2030. Right. So the list, there are around 17 Sustainable Development Goals that have been added by United Nations, and they need to be completed by 2030. And for that purpose, China has completed it around 9 to 10 years before the list, as per their declaration. And Facebook has banned Myanmar military from its operations with immediate effect, and that is from all of its platforms. That is from WhatsApp, from Instagram, from Facebook. All of these platforms have banned Myanmar military operations because Myanmar military had conducted coup recently, and that is something which is not being, you know, favored for all around the world anyway. Then Union Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports has restored the recognition of Gymnastics Federation of India as National Sports Federation. So since it has been restored, therefore the president post and the treasurer post is going to remain to the same people for the tenure of 2019 to 2023. That is Sudhir Mittal as president and Kaushik Bidiwala as the post of treasurer. Now, apart from that, whenever there is a sports involvement, there is a certain code that needs to be followed. That is the Sports Code of India, National Sports Development Code of India, which is also called as National Sports Development Code of India, which was framed in 2011. So as of now, there are certain updates to happen, but currently 2011 code is being followed, and GFI also needs to follow the same code, right? All right, then we have Niti Aayog and Invest India. They have associated with National Bamboo Mission, and they are going to conduct a national conference on opportunities and challenges for bamboo in India. NSO, National Statistical Office, has recently released certain new GDP forecast, or you can say it has revised a certain GDP forecast. So what is the revision about? So according to this, first of all, the economy expansion in December quarter is going to be by 0.4%. Second of all, the contractions of GDP have been revised. So for June quarter, the GDP contractions were 24.4% as compared to earlier 23 point some percentage, approximately it was 23.9%, which was there earlier. That has been revised to 24.4% now. Second of all, for September quarter, earlier predictions were around 7.5%. They have been reduced to 7.3% for September quarter, right? Then a deeper contraction of 8% is, you know, expected by NSO possibility, right? Then Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi will be receiving CERAWeek Global Energy and Global Energy and Environment Leadership Award soon. And this is going to be for the efforts that have been put forth by the Prime Minister of India for future development of various projects for future inclusion of energy projects, especially, or bringing in renewable energy, seeking in or keeping in mind the future prospects or the future country, future that is there in energy sector, right? So seeking to that, this has been set around, or this prize is going to be given to the Prime Minister of India. Then Indian Oil is going to raise the capacity of Panipat refinery soon to 500,000 BPD. Then DGCA has announced flight operators to give concessions to travelers with no baggage. So as of now in domestic flights, 15 kgs external baggage can be taken. So anyone who does not carry it, for them, the concession is going to be given to travelers, and that has been allowed by DGCA to flight operators. Now, does it involve the cabin also, the cabin baggage? No, cabin baggage can be carried, but for extra baggage, if they are not carrying, if someone is not carrying that extra baggage, then they can, they are eligible for getting these concessions. Right. Then the second Khelo India Winter Games were held in Gulmarg in Jammu and Kashmir. Recently, Khelo India Winter Games were all, Winter Games were recently held in Kargil. Right, and now the second Khelo India Winter Games are going to be held in Gulmarg in Jammu and Kashmir. Apart from that, the Khelo India University Games were organized recently, and they are going to be held in Karnataka. Right. So with this, we'll be winding up the segment. Thank you so much. It has been wonderful interacting with all of you, and I hope this session has been helpful to all of you. We'll see you tomorrow with more such news events and more such detailed discussion. Until then, download Entry app from Google Play Store. Further updates, do like the video and share the video as much as you can. See you tomorrow with more such updates. Have a great day ahead.